शुपादाय कृष्ण प्रश्चाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामिनिति नामिनी नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रश्चाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिनी नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादि पश्चत्य देशतारिणी ओम ज्ञान तिमिरांध्रस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुर्मीलितमेन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेहं श्री गुरु श्रीयुत पद कमलं श्री गुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्री रूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्री राधा कृष्ण पादान सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगत्पदे गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसूतिने देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वर परम कृष्ण सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादि राधि गोविंदा सर्व कारण कारणम हरे कृष्ण। माय लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णास कॉसलेस मर्सी वी आर नाइसली प्रोग्रेसिंग इन 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 द 8th चैप्टर ऑफ भगवत गीता सो वी फिनिश्ड अबाउट 12 श्लोकास। फॉर दोस हु हैव जॉइंड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम व्हिच आई ऑलवेज से इन एवरी क्लास बिकॉज़ it's nice that every week, every day, we are getting new devotees are joining in our Bhagavad Gita class from different parts of the world. So, Bhagavad Gita, we are going to cover all these slokas. So, even though we are in the 8th chapter now, that doesn't mean that you are going to miss something, because I am going to revise all these slokas from different chapters. Because Bhagavad Gita itself is the king of knowledge. And here we need to understand all these slokas very well, so that we will be able to consult Bhagavad Gita when we want to do in our each and every activity. We should be able to consult with Bhagavad Gita reference. Bhagavad Gita is a reference book where we should be always able to go back to Bhagavad Gita. And when we want to do some work, whether it is the right thing to do or whether we should do it or not, all the time we should actually refer to Bhagavad Gita. That is the main thing. So that means this Bhagavad Gita knowledge, we should know ourselves, we should completely know in full. Only thing, we should be able to go and find out which chapter, which shloka, what Krishna is saying. To that extent, we should know it. So, because this Bhagavad Gita knowledge, when we are able to refer to Bhagavad Gita, when we are able to do our activities as per the guidance given by Bhagavad Gita, then we will not be bound by any of the reactions. That is the main point. The main point we need to understand from Bhagavad Gita is that our actions should not bind us. So that way we should be able to liberate ourselves. So we should be able to free ourselves. So dridena chitva, that is asanga sastram. So that is the weapon what we have in our hand. So that is the asanga sastram. Asanga sastram means the weapon of detachment. So repeatedly we are studying that is possible only by ourselves getting attached to Krishna. So by studying this Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is giving us the knowledge about himself very well and about ourselves. So that way we know what is right and what is wrong. So that way we know Krishna is saying very clearly in Bhagavad Gita, one should never ever give up the activities which are performed as yajna, dana, tapa, karma. So we need to understand one thing. We know we are in this material world because we are not fully pure. Even though the Atma is pure, the soul is pure, but still we are contaminated in this material world and we are struggling and we are suffering. The very reason we are in this material world itself shows that we need to purify ourselves. So the only way to purify ourselves is to act in such a way that we are not bound by the reactions. So we need to prove, because we need to become ourselves eligible to go to Krishna's world. We need to meet what is the eligibility criteria? What is the eligibility requirements? Even when we want to apply, when we want to immigrate to some countries where the lifestyle is better. So one has to meet a lot of eligibilities. Otherwise, you can't even move. So like that, here we want to permanently, so permanently immigrate to Krishna's world, that is Golokam. So once we go there, then there is no way. It is only one way. Only we can go there. Once we go there, then we will not come back here at all. So that's what Krishna is repeatedly saying in Bhagavad Gita. Once you come to my place, then you are not going to fall down. We are not going to come back and suffer in this material world once we go to Krishna's world. So, but we need to meet the eligibility criteria. So we need to meet the eligibility requirements. So that means we should be completely free ourselves from all kinds of attachments in this material world. And how can we prove that we are freed from all attachments? Only by acting, only by performing our duties. That is the way we can prove. That is the test for us. So in that test, we need to perform, we need to do all our activities and prove that we are not disturbed by the results. We are not affected by the results. So that is possible only, so any test you need to prepare, correct? Without preparing, we cannot go and write any exams. So that way, we need to first study. So prepare means we need to study. So here we need to study this Bhagavad Gita. We need to understand this Bhagavad Gita. If we study and understand this Bhagavad Gita fully, that means we are preparing for our test every day, which is happening. It's a daily in our life, every day, all activities, whatever activities we are doing, everything is a test for us. And we need to pass continuously. So we should not fail at all. So then only we become eligible to go to Krishna's world at the time of death. So that's why antakale. So esa brahmi sthiti partha. So that means if we pass this test and we should be situated in that status, esa brahmi sthiti partha nainam prapya vimukhyati sthitvasyam antakale. So we need to be in that status until the time of death. Prak sarira vimokshana. We should be able to control the urge, the control the speed, which is the urge coming from kama and krodha until the time of death. So that's why in this life, we need to achieve that status of not getting disturbed by anything, not getting bothered by anything, not getting affected by anything. So we need to achieve that status as quickly as possible and then be in this status until the time of our death. So if that is the eligibility requirement. So if we are able to maintain that status, that is known as sthita prajna. Sthita prajna means whose intelligence is very well situated. So that means Krishna is saying that one who is not disturbed in mind when there is distress and one who is not elated when there is happiness and one who is free from attachment, fear and anger. Vita, raga, bhaya, krodha. So that means it is known as sthita prajna. So we need to achieve that status of sthita prajna. So in this life itself, we should aim to become ourselves a sthita prajna. It means a self-realized person. So that way Bhagavad Gita teaches us how to become a sthita prajna. So that way Krishna is saying that yas sarvatrana visnehaga tattat prapya subasubam nabinandati nadvesti tasya prajna pratisthitam. Yas sarvatrana visnehaga. So one who is not attached to anything is sarvatra nabisnegaga tattat prapya subha asubham. So when we get subha, so that means the good results, the results what we want, subham. And asubham, asubham means the bad results, the results which we don't want. So tattat prapya subha asubham na abhinandadi na dvesti. So when we get the good results, we should not be praising it, and na dvesti, when we get bad results, we should not be disturbed. So that's what we should not hate it. So that means we should be equal. So when we get good results, we should not be praising that too much. When we get bad results, we should not be disturbed by it. We should not be hating it. So that's what avarsan. So na dvesti. So na abhinandati na dvesti. Tasya prajna pratisthita. And his prajna and his intelligence is very well situated. Tasya prajna pratisthita. So how are we going to achieve that status? How are you going to achieve that status of not getting disturbed by anything? That is possible only by acting, only by doing our duty, only by knowing what we are supposed to do. So we cannot do anything and everything and say that I am doing the duty. We should do only the prescribed duties. That's why niyatam, niyatam kuru karmatvam. So it has to be prescribed duties. and how will we know what are the prescribed duties and what we can do and what we should do and what we should not do? How we know that? Everything is given only in Bhagavad Gita. Only if we study Bhagavad Gita and understand this Bhagavad Gita fully, then only we know what we should do and what we should not do. That's why Krishna is saying that one should know karmanohi api bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha akarmanaka, vikarmanascha bodhavyam. One should know about karma, akarma, vikarma, everything one should know. So what one should do, what one should not do, and what are the forbidden activities, all such things. That's why bodhavyam, bodhavyam, three times Krishna is saying that karmanohi api bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha vikarmanaka, akarmanascha bodhavyam. Gahana karmano gati. So, how will we know what is the right thing to do? How will we know what action is going to bind us and what action is going to liberate us from this material world? Only by knowing Bhagavad Gita. Only by understanding Bhagavad Gita. So, just by understanding this Bhagavad Gita fully, fully understanding this Bhagavad Gita, all the 18 chapters, 700 shlokas, so then we know what is the right, what is the wrong thing. And we can very easily say that whatever we do it for Krishna, keeping Krishna in mind, keeping Krishna at the center. So Krishna is there in our heart and all the time remembering Krishna. So whatever we do for Krishna, we are doing it right. Everything we do it for Krishna, it is going to free us. It's going to liberate us from this material bondage. But if anything we do for ourselves, forgetting Krishna, completely ignoring Krishna, if we do anything for ourselves, for our satisfaction, so then that is going to bind us. Even the food what we eat, every day we are eating, every day, every meal we are eating. And Krishna is simply saying that, you just love me. If you love me, you offer it to me. So if you love someone, we don't just eat ourselves. We'll wait for that person to eat. If we love someone, if we invite a guest, if someone is there with us, and we will not just eat ourselves just by ignoring. So Krishna is there with us all the time. So we should offer it to him. So Krishna, it doesn't mean that Krishna is not taking away food and the food is not getting reduced and it is exactly in the same form. That doesn't mean that we cannot offer to Krishna, because Krishna, what he expects from us, the love. Krishna expects the love and devotion. So that's why Krishna is saying that if you just offer the food to me and eat, then you are free from all the reactions. Because when we are eating the food, that itself is an action. And if you don't offer to Krishna, we are actually binding ourselves just by eating the food. Just by eating the food, we are binding ourselves. Then what to speak about people who eat the meat, who eat the meat, fish, non-vegetarian things? It's very difficult. There is no way, because Krishna is saying very clearly, Ignasista Sinaga Santo Muchyante Sarva Kilbisayi. If anyone who offers to me first and then they honor the prasadam, then they are freed from all sins. Muchyante Sarva Kilbisayi. But Bunjate Te Tu Agam Papa Ye Pachanti Atma Karana. But those who prepare food for their sense gratification, for gratifying their tongue, they verily eat only sins. That's what Krishna is saying. So starting from what we are eating every day, starting from what we are doing every day, so each and every activity should be offered to Krishna. That is the main thing. So that means every meal, every food, every time we eat, we need to offer to Krishna. Out of love and devotion, that's what Krishna wants. So that way, we have to do everything for Krishna. That is the main thing in our life. Krishna is only at the center. Krishna is everything for us. So that's what is known as Krishna consciousness. Then only we can be able to, we will be become eligible to go to Krishna's way. If we are not ready to remember Krishna, if we are so much involved in this material world, material things, if we say that I don't have any time, I don't have any time to think about Krishna. I don't have any time to study Bhagavad Gita. I don't have any time to serve Krishna. So like that, if we think, then we will get more and more time to serve in this material world in the future lives. We are going to be here forever. keep on taking birth, keep on getting ourselves busy in this material world, and keep on doing all these nonsense things in this material world. If we feel, if we think that I'm so busy, I don't have any time to read Bhagavad Gita or to remember Krishna, so that means we will never get time. But the problem, the unfortunate situation is that we will keep coming back to this material world again and again. That is a very, very unfortunate situation we need to understand. Because we will keep coming back to this material world and we will keep on taking birth in this material world. We keep ourselves very busy in this material world. And unfortunately, every time at the time of death, we will lose everything. All hard-earned money, properties, our name, our fame, certificates, degrees, awards, whatnot. Everything we can list. We can say that I have so much. All the things. But nothing is going to help at the time of death. And we are not going to take anything with us at the time of death. And no one is going to remember after we die. Everything we are going to lose. So ultimately we will be the loser. When we live here, we may feel ourselves very proud that people are really praising me. I am great. I have so much of talent. I am doing this. I am doing that. All such things. But when death comes, everything is taken away completely. So one should be intelligent enough to use this time wisely. This human life is very precious. We cannot simply lose this opportunity. It's a great opportunity that we should completely utilize it to realize ourselves and to do everything for Krishna in relationship with Krishna as an offering unto Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. That's why this Bhagavad Gita knowledge is very, very, very important for us. Extremely important knowledge for us. Unfortunately, no school and college, they teach this Bhagavad Gita. And to gain this material knowledge, we have to struggle very hard and we have to pay heavy. We have to pay so much of fees actually. We pay so much of fees to gain the knowledge and again we will work to pay, repay the loans. But this Bhagavad Gita, to know about ourselves, it's totally free of cost. No need to pay anyone anything. It's simply our free will. Simply if you want to know about ourselves, if you want to free ourselves from this material world, then Krishna is there in our heart and he's going to create an opportunity for us to understand this most confidential knowledge. This is the topmost, ultimate, most confidential knowledge. Topmost secret. Guhya Uttamam. Rahasyam yetad uttamam. So paramam guhyam. So we are getting that knowledge. So when we get this knowledge, when we use it in our life is going to become so much wonderful, so much beautiful. Because the first thing is that we are not going to worry about anything. We are not going to be disturbed by anything. Our mind will be very peaceful and very blissful. Because with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, when we are connected with Krishna, there is no time to worry about anything in this material world. That is the main thing. We will become even much busier than the so-called busy people in this world. We will become even busier in serving Krishna, remembering Krishna, and all the time doing everything for Krishna. So there won't be any time for us to think about this material things in this material world. That's all going to happen only if we get this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. That's what we are gaining. That's what we are getting. And this is a very rare opportunity. And Krishna is giving us this opportunity. And we are studying that same Bhagavad Gita Krishna gave to Arjuna. Just 5,000 years ago in the battlefield, whatever Arjuna learned from Krishna, we are studying the same Bhagavad Gita as it is. By the grace of Srila Prabhupada, we are just studying Bhagavad Gita as it is. So that way, if we study and understand this fully, there is no doubt that we are going to go to Krishna as well. That's why Krishna is using the word Mamevaisisi Asamsaya. Many times Krishna has used this line. Mamevaisisi Asamsaya. Mamevaisisi Asamsaya. You will come to me, there is no doubt about it. A very important, powerful words, powerful sentence Krishna is teaching us. Giving knowledge Krishna is giving us. Mamevaisisi Asamsaya. Krishna is promising me. Satyamte. I pratityano priyosimi. I promised you. That's what Krishna is saying. So manmana bhava madbhakto madhyaji maam namaskuru maamevaisisi satyam satyam te. It is the truth, it is the fake. pratijano. So I am promising to you, satyam te pratijano priyosime, priyosime. Oh my dear, you are so much dearer to me, priyosime. So I don't want you to suffer in this material world, my dear. I don't want you to suffer and struggle in this material world. This is a place for miseries and this is a temporary place. And don't struggle in this material world and just think about me. Just focus your mind on me. Just always worship me and become my devotee and offer your obeisances unto me. You are going to come to me. I promise you. There is no doubt about it. That's what Krishna is saying, that satyam te pratijanu priyosimi. Krishna is promising. Mamevaisasi asamsa. Many, many times. So if you just know about Krishna, if you just know who Krishna is, if you just know that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead without any doubt, and if you know about the transcendental nature of Krishna's appearance and activities, then we are simply going to go to Krishna's way, because our mind will be filled with Krishna all the time. There is no time to remember about anything in this material way. So whatever we do, we will do it only for Krishna, only as an offering. That's what we are studying in the 8th chapter now, attaining the Supreme. The title of the 8th chapter is Attaining the Supreme. So Krishna is saying that prayana kale manasa chalena bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva gruvor madhye pranam avesya samyak satam param purusham upaiti dipi. So at the time of death, prayana kale, so keeping our mind very stable, not disturbed at all, manasa chalena. So by using the strength what we have got, what we have obtained by doing devotional service unto Krishna, so that's why bhaktya yukto yoga balena chaiva, then we will be able to bring our life here between the two eyebrows and then we can go to Krishna's bed. So yadaksharam vedavido vadanti visanti atyatayo vitaragaga yadichantho brahmacharyam charanti tatte padam sangrahena pravakshi. So I shall explain to you everything. Whatever Krishna is saying, that I shall explain to you how to reach Yadaksharam, Veda Vido, that Aksharam, that Brahman, how to reach that Brahman. Veda Vido Vadanti, those who knows the Vedas, who describe about it. So I shall explain to you now so that you can come to me. That's what in the sloka, last sloka we studied in the 8th chapter, 12th sloka, Krishna said that sarvadwarani samyamya mano kriti niruddhyacha murnyadyatmanaga pranam astito yoga dharanam. So sarvadwarani samyamya, by controlling all the gates in our body. I explained that in the last class, that totally there are 9 gates in our body. Sarvadwaram, 9 gates. Navadwaram. Sarvadwaram, navadwaram. So in this sloka, Krishna is saying sarvadwaram in the 8th chapter, 12th sloka. In the 5th chapter, in one sloka, Krishna is saying that navadwaram pure. Navadware pure devi. So 2 eyes, 2 nostrils, and 2 ears, and 1 mouth, and 1 anus, and 1 genital. So totally it makes 9 dwaras, 9 openings, 9 gates in our body. So here Krishna is saying that sarvadwarani samyamya manohriddhi niruddhyacha. So by fixing our mind on the heart where Krishna is there, so manohriddhi niruddhyacha murdhnyadi atmanaga pranam, by bringing our atma, by soul, by bringing ourselves to the head and between the eyebrows, if we leave this body, we'll go to Krishna. So in this sloka today, what we are studying in the 13th sloka, in the 8th chapter, Krishna is continuing then. Omite kaksharam brahma vyaharan ma manusmaran yaprayati tyajandeham sayati paramam gati. So Brahman is Om. The syllable Om refers to the Brahman. That is Krishna's abode also. Brahman is Krishna's abode. And we are also Brahman. So yada, Krishna says Aksharam Brahma Paramam. So we are also the soul. We belong to Brahman. That's why we need to become a Brahma Bhuta, not Jiva Bhuta. So Brahma Bhuta means we need to realize that we are not connected with this material world. So that means we should completely forget about this material world. We should only remember about Krishna. So that's why Omiteka Aksharam Brahmam. So the word Om, the syllable Om, not the word, the syllable Om. So there is Eka, there is one Akshara. So Omiteka Aksharam Brahmam Vyaharan Mamanusmaran. So by reciting, by uttering that syllable Om, and one remembers me. That's why Vyaharan Ma Manusmaran. I know it's recommended for us to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is same as Krishna only. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 500 years ago, he is Krishna's avatar. Krishna himself came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he gave us this mantra, Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. And we come through their disciplic succession. So that way, we are now knowing, studying Bhagavad Gita, because we are coming in their disciplic succession from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So then we gave them Srila Prabhupada, who gave this knowledge. And my Guru Maharaj also is Prabhupada's disciple. So that way, we are getting this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita in a disciplic succession. So here, the recommended mantra for us to is to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra all the time. So remember Krishna. But Krishna is also recommending here that Omitteka Aksharam Brahma Vyaharan Ma Manusmaran. So if anyone remembers me at the time of death by chanting the Om, the syllable Om. So again, I'm telling one more thing very important. Let's not worry about all these things. What is going to happen us at the time of death? Whether we will be able to remember Krishna, go there or not. Or whether we'll be able to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra or Om Mantra, all such things. We will leave it to Krishna. That is the meaning. Because Krishna knows, Krishna is there in our heart. What we are supposed to do now is to serve Krishna. That is the main thing. Nothing else. And chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. That's it. Nothing else. So we need to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra to control our mind. So that is the way to control our mind. So by chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, by focusing our mind on the transcendental sound vibration, then we will be able to control our mind. As we discussed very, very in detail in the last class during the question answer session, like mind is wavering, mind is not going to sit in one place, mind is going to go here and there, and we need to bring back that mind and focus on the transcendental sound vibration of Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. When we do this, when we focus our mind on the transcendental sound vibration, so we know for sure that our mind is not going to stay there. It's going to go here and there. But if we do this exercise, if we do this practice, it is a mind exercise. Like a body exercise, we do it and we keep our body very fit, six-pack, all such things, we are able to maintain our body. So similarly, if we do this exercise for our mind, so then our mind is going to fix on that Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. It's not going to go here and there. So that's why it's very, very important. So that way, by Krishna's mercy, if we just do that and control our mind, if we study Bhagavad Gita and understand the entire, all the slokas in Bhagavad Gita and do everything as an offering unto Krishna, and ultimately, the very, very important, topmost, ultimate service to Krishna is just taking and giving this, spreading this knowledge to others. This Bhagavad Gita. That's it. If we simply do this one task, this one important service to Krishna, everything else is taken care of very nicely. We don't have to worry about it. Krishna will make sure we will go to Krishna at the time of death. That's why Krishna is saying that Ya idam paramam guhyam madbhakte swabhidasyati bhaktim mayi param kritva mam eva isasi asamsaya. As I said in the middle of today's lecture, Krishna is using this word very often, using this line sentence very often. Mam eva isasi asamsaya. You will come to me, there is no doubt about it. Who will come to go to Krishna? One who gives this knowledge to others. That's it. Ya idam paramam guhyam madbhakte swavidasini. When anyone explains this topmost confidential knowledge to my devotees, then they will come to me. I guarantee their devotional service unto me. Bhakti mayi param kritva. Bhakti mayi param kritva. If you really love Krishna, if you really have bhakti towards Krishna, bhakti. So if you are Krishna's devotee, Krishna bhakta, then the important job, important service we need to do is, this is the job, nothing else. Just take this knowledge, just understand this knowledge and carry this knowledge and spread this knowledge and give it to everyone, share this knowledge to everyone. That's what we are supposed to do. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, Krishna is saying that yaprayati tajandegam sayati paramam gatim. So then When we give up this body, he will come to me. Sayati Paramam Gati means he will attain the supreme destination, Paramam Gati. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished today the sloka number 13 in the 8th chapter, Hare Krishna. And we'll discuss if any questions are there. I will leave and hand over to Siva Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Guruji. We don't have any questions, but there are new participants.
Okay.
I will unmute one by one.